Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, you have to see the complete details about SBI PO mains exam strategy tips as well as the expected cutoff also. So watch this video till the end to get all the useful information. So coming to the exam pattern now, let's see the brief of introduction of the exam pattern. You'll have the reasoning and computer aptitude for 60 marks, where you will be having 45 questions, and coming to the data analysis and interpretation, 35 questions, 60 marks, and coming to the general awareness, you will be having 40 questions and 40 marks. Coming to the English, you will be having 30 questions and 30 marks. In total, you will be having 155 questions and 200 marks and 3 hours of time. Now let's see what are the most important topics you need to concentrate coming to SBI PO mains 2019. So coming to the SBI PO mains, most important topics for data analysis and interpretation, you need to concentrate on data interpretation, that is the tabular graph, bar graph or pie chart, like you know, they out of these three, they may ask you any question related to the data interpretation, because it is one of the most important topic which is surely asked each and every year for SBI PO mains 2019. So please concentrate on pie chart, bar graph, line graph and also tabular graph or table format. So, and few more important topics are, you need to concentrate on data sufficiency. Okay, the more you practice, the more score you can get. So coming to the basic topics which are important are permutations and combinations. Coming to permutations and combinations as well as probability, you'll be having the few formulae, the standard formulae. If you remember that, you can solve any particular question coming to probability or permutation and combination within less than 40 seconds or even 30 seconds if you practice well. So follow the standard books which have the correct formulae, apt formulae for these particular topics, that is permutation and combination as well as probability. So if you follow those books, you find the formulae, like only the basic formulae less than 5 or 6. If you are stuck to that formula, you can solve any particular question. Like it may be any question, like let them ask any question, you can solve within less than 30 seconds. And few more topics which are very important coming to the reasoning are, concentrate on circular arrangement as well as linear arrangement. Like coming to the seating arrangement, they may ask you any particular question. They may ask you circular arrangement, linear arrangement, or they may ask you giving the questions such as all the people are sitting by facing towards the center or against the center, like that. So coming to the tip regarding solving of the seating arrangement questions, what you need to do is, you have to imagine the picture in your mind, keep yourself there, imagine the picture in your mind and then solve the problem. It really helps you to solve within less than 40 seconds. And coming to the another important topics, you have to concentrate on blood relations. Coming to the blood relations, this is the most common tip which helps you a lot. Coming to the blood relations, start reading the question from last to first. First read the original question, such as how is A related to B, or how is some person related to the person who is in the photo. Okay, so like that. So read the sentence and then start reading the question from last to first. This really helps you to solve any kind of question, any kind of difficulty level question or from blood relations very easily. So this is the tip, read the question of blood relation from last to first. Okay, so another more few more important questions are coding and decoding. Coming to the coding and decoding, the more you practice, the more score you get. So keep practicing more and more. So these are the few most important topics coming to reasoning. So coming to the English, the most important topics are reading comprehension. So reading comprehension is one of the question which helps you to score more marks. So coming to the reading comprehension, the most important tip which you need to follow is that first read the question and then automatically you can start searching the answer for that related question, because you already have the knowledge about the question. So then if you have the knowledge about the question, automatically you can concentrate on the answer and you can search the answer very quickly compared to the previous method. Like most of the students follow the old method, like first they read entire paragraph and then they read the question. That is the old old method which wastes a lot of time. So this is the new method. First read the question and then start searching the answer for that particular question. It saves a lot of time, trust me. So coming to English, the first important topic which I told you is reading comprehension, and then concentrate on vocabulary as well as grammar. You should be really good at grammar. And next, concentrate on spotting the errors as well as close test. Close test is one of the most important topics, and also para-jumbles as well. So coming to the important topics, coming to the awareness, concentrate on general awareness, like, you know, the current affairs in general awareness. At least you should have the knowledge of the last 6 months of current affairs which happened, and also concentrate on banking affairs, as this is the exam which is related to bank. You should have the current affairs knowledge which are even related to the bank, and you should have the knowledge about, like, you know, the places, capital, the basic general knowledge, okay, and sports as well. So they may ask you any question regarding to the general awareness. So this is the most important section, and this is the section where most of the students keep losing the marks. So concentrate on this particular section. Read the Hindu paper or any two standard newspapers, and watch at least 1 hour. Like, you know, you need to watch the news channels at least 1 hour daily. So coming to the computer knowledge, the most important topics is you have to have the complete knowledge about the basic shortcuts which you use regarding, like, you know, while operating the system. And you should have the complete knowledge about the Microsoft, like the MS Office, MS PowerPoint and all. And also you should have the knowledge about the hardware as well as the software and networking. So these are the few important topics related to the computer. So now let's see what is the cutoff, expected cutoff coming to the SBI mains, SBI PO mains 2019. So after this, I would like to give you a few important tips, so stay tuned. So coming to the cutoff for SBI PO mains exam, the 2019, this is the expected cutoff. So out of the entire marks for SC, you should get at least 78 marks as cutoff. And for ST, the cutoff is 76. For OBC, it is 87. For general category, it is 94. And for other categories, it is based upon your reservation and all. So the most important topic, the most important thing which you need to remember is the cutoff keeps changing each and every year. If the paper is really tough, the cutoff comes down. If the paper is so easy, the cutoff increases. So concentrate on scoring more marks. Obviously, you can cross the cutoff and then you can crack this particular exam. So coming to the most important tips and strategy which I would like to tell you, people who are going to attend this particular exam, is that first you need to concentrate on the topics which you have already learned, and the topics which has high weightage, high importance, okay? Because these particular topics will help you to easily cross the cutoff, okay? The second important topic is refer to at least last 8 to 10 years of previous papers, so that you have the knowledge of what sort of questions are asked regularly and what sort of difficulty level is coming in the exam, okay? And the fourth important topic is that everything which you learn the whole entire day, keep revising at night so that you can remember it for so long. So when you start revising the topics in the very same day, you remember it for so long, and you also can solve the questions easily in the exam. And fifth is manage your time well, because this is one of the particular exam where most of the students runs out of the time. Manage your time, solve the question within the time. Like, first of all, prepare yourself, like how much time you need to allocate for that particular question. Don't waste most time for the questions which gives you 1 or 2 marks, okay? So, and another important topic is keep giving mock tests, and thereby you can analyze your performance and analyze your speed of solving also. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to do more and more videos regarding SBI PO mains and also SBI PO interview. So what you need to do is you have to subscribe to my channel, hit the bell icon for more such video notifications, like and share this video with all the candidates or your friends who are going to attend this exam as well. So all the very best, be confident. I will also do SBI PO mains paper analysis and exam analysis video also. So stay tuned to this channel, and all the very best. Be confident, don't be panicked, and reach the exam center at least before 1 hour so that you can calm down, you can relax yourself, and which helps you to remember the answers easily within less time in exam time, in during exam. So thanks for watching, all the best, and crack the exam. Like, share, subscribe.